Good day everybody. In this video I will explain how we analyze data from triaxial tests on rocks using Mohr-Coulomb failure criteria. So let's look at the test data. So we have performed several tests, so six tests, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And for each test we use confining pressure sigma 3. And we measured maximum stress, which is principal stress at failure, sigma 1. So we have six sets of data from six tests, and they are presented in the table. So what we need to find is friction angle and cohesion using the Mohr-Coulomb failure criteria. Well, let's first look at this equation, and you're probably familiar with this one. So this is Mohr-Coulomb failure criteria for soil. So in this case, we always we deal with shear strength for soil because soil is very weak material and it fails in shear. So you will see that the strength of soil depends on the normal stress, depends on the friction angle and cohesion. So kind of similar criteria we can have for rocks, and it shows here. I'm not going to show how we arrive at this criteria. So if you're interested in learning more, please check textbooks on rock mechanics. So what we're going to use is just this equation, and I will show you how to use this equation to obtain friction angle and cohesion. So you will see we have cohesion here and we have friction angle here. So for rocks, we typically use stresses. We use principal stresses sigma 1 and sigma 3. We don't really care much about shear strength of rocks because if rock is fresh and hard, shear strength is going to be very, very high. So we prefer to use principal stresses, and these are principal stresses at failure. We can put F. F means failure. Okay, now let's see how we can use this formula and how we can analyze data from this table to obtain friction angle and cohesion. So the first thing that we will do is to draw the data. So we have sigma 1 and sigma 3. So let's put it here on this graph, and I've already done this. So here we have confining pressure at failure, sigma 3. So let's look at the first set of data. In this case, sigma 3 is 0, so 0.0, and sigma 1 will be 25, so it's here. That's the first point. Then second point, we continue, sigma 3 is 5, and sigma 1 will be 60. So we just continue plotting the data, and we're going to have 6 points. And what we'll need to do next is to draw a line of best fit. So what I would recommend is to use Excel. That's what I did. If you don't have Excel or you don't know how to use it, then you will draw it by hand. So what we need to get from this plot, we need to get the characteristics of this line. So this is a failure envelope. And the good thing about Excel, it will give you this equation. So that's the equation. So if we look at this equation, you will see that it looks pretty similar to what we have here. And I'm going to rewrite this equation at sigma 1 at failure equal sigma 3 times tangent in the power of 2. 45 plus friction angle divided by 2 and plus sigma c. So if we look at this equation and we know what we plotted, you will see that this y, it's actually sigma 1, correct? And this one x here, it's will be sigma 3, correct? So that's the data we plotted. So this means that this component of the equation 3167 is going to be this sigma c, what we also call the unconfined compression strength. So we can get from this equation already that and confined compression strength is 31,667 MPa. Well, if we look at the graph, we will see this is the point where the failure envelope crosses the sigma 1 axis. So this point is 31,667. I'll round it a bit. So remember what we need to do is to get this value from 6 points, not just from 1 point from one test. If you look at the first test, when we have confining pressure of 0, you will see that the data will go 25. So this one, right? So many people will say, okay, unconfined compressive strength will be 25. Well, if you do only one test, and that's your only test, in this case, you can say, okay, that's 25. But if we have 6 points, we're going to go with the 6 points, because 6 test results will give us more accurate data compared to just only one test. So if we analyze all the 6 test results, we will find out that unconfined compressive strength, sigma c, is 31,670 MPa. Okay, so now let's move on, and we're going to look at this component, which is, say, 4.56 times x, right? So we know that x is sigma 3 at failure, and it's going to be here, sigma 3 at failure, which means that 4.56, that will be this one. So I'm going to rewrite it here. I'm going to write that 4.56 is equal tangent in the power of 2 of 45 degrees plus pressure angle divided by 2. Again, this is what we get from the graph, from the plot, right? So we don't really need to do much calculations. Well, I hope you know how to solve this one. If you still don't know how to do, well, I'd call it simple math, then first we're gonna get the tangent 45 plus 5 divided by 2. So we get a square root of 4.56, and it's gonna be 2.135. So tangent of 2.135 is approximately 64.9 degrees. So I can write like this, 64.9 degrees. So 5 divided by 2 is equal to 90.9 degrees, which means that friction angle will be 39.8 degrees, right? Okay, so we found friction angle. Now we're gonna put it in this equation because we need to find cohesion. And this first part of the equation, it gives us cohesion here. So this is the cohesion. So what we're going to do is, well, if you look at this formula here, and here and here, right? So if this one is sigma 1 at failure and this one is sigma 3 at failure, so if we have confining pressure sigma 3f at failure equal to 0, then as we already know that sigma 1f will be equal to 31.667, right? So what we're gonna do is here, sigma 1 will be 31.67. This sigma 3, we assume that it's a 0, no confining pressure. In this case, we can simplify this equation to this form, 2 times cohesion times tangent 45 degrees. Plus, we already know that friction angle is 39.8 divided by 2, and that will be equal to 31.67. So this is the second equation that I'm sure you'll be able to solve by yourself. We have only one unknown, which is cohesion. And from here, you will get that cohesion is approximately, what is the cohesion? I think it's 7.6 MPa from top of my head. So, well, check it, guys. If it's not correct, just let me know in your comments. Okay, so this is how we analyze data from triaxial test using Mohr-Coulomb failure criteria. I hope you learned this technique and you're going to use it in practice. Thanks for watching this video. Have a nice day. Bye.